going to see the large-scale manufacture of sulfuric acid through the process of contact process. Now, I'm having the diagram here. I would like to illustrate the diagram. Therefore, the raw materials for this process is sulfur and air, sulfur and oxygen. Now, sulfur and air are being burned, are reacted, sulfur and air, to form sulfur 4 oxide. That means sulfur reacts sulfur plus oxygen gas to form sulfur 4 oxide gas. Remember, there's one sulfur, two oxygen, the equation is balanced. From this, this sulfur 4 oxide contains impurities. This sulfur oxide, it contains impurities. And remember, these impurities, they can harm the catalyst. Therefore, we use this sulfur oxide. Now it's passed through electrostatic precipitation. This is used to remove the impurities such as dust, because this sulfur oxide, it contains dust particles. That's an impurity, it can harm the catalyst. Therefore, we pass through electrostatic precipitation to remove the impurities. Then it is dried. We use sulfuric acid to dry. Sulfuric acid. That's where these things take place, the cleaner and the dryer. This is where the sulfur oxide, the impurities is removed, and also it is dried. We use electrostatic precipitation process to remove the impurities, and also we use sulfuric acid to dry the gas. After that, the gas is passed through a heat exchanger. This heat exchanger is used to burn the gas from the catalytic chamber, which is sulfur 6 oxide. Then, here at the catalytic chamber, the sulfur 4 oxide is reacted or burned with oxygen. It means if we react sulfur 4 oxide plus oxygen, we get sulfur 6 oxide gas. Remember this, one sulfur, three, four oxygen. So this thing, oxygen is not balanced. We have to balance the oxygen. It means now here we have 4 oxygen, and here we have to put here. If we put here 2, we'll have 6 oxygen. 2 times 2 plus 4, 6 oxygen. 2 sulfur. The equation is balanced. This means sulfur 4 oxide reacting with oxygen to form sulfur 6 oxide. But the formation of this gas has three conditions, optimum condition. We have here the optimum condition for sulfur 6 oxide. Remember, we have a temperature of 450 degrees Celsius, we have pressure of 2 atmosphere, then the catalyst used here is vanadium 5 oxide. These are the conditions for the formation of sulfur 6 oxide. 450 degrees Celsius, 2 atmosphere, and the catalyst of vanadium 5 oxide. Those are the three conditions for formation of sulfur 6 oxide gas. Remember, instead of this vanadium 5 oxide, we might use platinum asbestos. But remember, platinum asbestos is expensive, and it can also easily be poisoned. That's why we prefer the vanadium 5 oxide. So after the conditions and the sulfur 6 oxide is formed, then here the absorption tower. Remember, this sulfur 6 oxide gas is not reacted directly with water. We can't react this gas to water direct, because this gas, the heat generated from here can boil the gas to form sulfuric acid in the air. That's why we don't directly react sulfur 6 oxide with water. Therefore, the first thing is we react sulfur 6 oxide gas reacted with sulfuric acid, H2SO4 liquid, to form oleum. We to form oleum H2S2O7 liquid. You can confirm there is two sulfur, there is seven oxygen, hydrogen two. So the equation is balanced. So the sulfur 6 oxide gas is reacted with sulfuric acid to form oleum. Then for us to get the sulfuric acid, the oleum formed is diluted in water. That oleum now is diluted in water. H2S2O7 liquid reacting with water liquid, then we'll get now sulfuric acid H2SO4. There's two hydrogen. Here we have two sulfur, so we need to balance the sulfur. Two sulfur. The equation is already balanced. We can confirm four hydrogen, two sulfur. Here we have oxygen. Here we have is 7 plus 1, 8. 4 times 2 is 8. Now the equation is balanced. This is the reaction. Sulfuric acid that we manufactured using the contact process. But one thing you have to remember is that when we are converting the sulfur 4 oxide to sulfur 6, when we are reacting this sulfur 4 to sulfur 6, not all the sulfur 4 oxide will react. It's assumed that only 98% of sulfur 4 oxide is converted to sulfur 6 oxide. The 2% remaining, if we allow sulfur 4 oxide to the air, this is a pollutant. It can cause pollution. Therefore, we use calcium sulfate. We use the calcium sulfide. So we write here calcium sulfide plus sulfuric acid to form calcium sulfide. Sorry, we don't use calcium sulfide. We use calcium hydroxide. I'm sorry for that. We don't use calcium sulfide. It's passed through calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide. Here we have aqueous plus sulfur 4 oxide gas plus sulfur 4 oxide gas to form calcium sulfide plus water liquid. One calcium. 2 oxygen plus 2 oxygen 4, 3 plus 1 4, 2 hydrogen. The equation is balanced. This process is called scrubbing of the gas. We call it scrubbing the gas when we pass through sulfur 4 oxide to calcium hydroxide, because this is a pollutant. That's all about the contact process. I like to repeat it for the second time so that it become easier for understanding. We said that sulfur and oxygen is combined to form sulfur 4 oxide. That sulfur 4 oxide, it contains impurities. That impurities, we use the process of electrostatic precipitation to remove the impurities, such as dust particles. Then the gas is dried using the sulfuric acid. After that, the gas is passed through a heat exchanger, whereby the sulfur 6 oxide from the catalytic chamber is used to heat. Then, sulfur 4 oxide is heated with oxygen. When we react sulfur 4 oxide plus oxygen to form sulfur 6 oxide, then we say that the sulfur 6 oxide gas formed is not directly reacted with water, because the heat generated here can boil the acid to produce sulfuric acid in the air. That's why we don't react sulfur 6 directly with water. We react first with sulfuric acid to form oleum. Then the oleum is diluted in water to get the sulfuric acid. Then we say that not all the sulfur 4 oxide will be converted to sulfur 6. Therefore, we pass through calcium hydroxide in the process called the scrubbing the gas. I hope that's a brief class for the contact process. We done the Selby, we done the Haber process. So we are only remaining with organic chemistry 1. We are going to do in our next presentation. So we are done with form 3 work. We go to organic chemistry 2. So we are also done with the organic chemistry. I hope you enjoyed the class. See you in the next time.